Hey friends, welcome back! In today's video, I will create a 3D model of an interior completely from scratch using the app SketchUp on my iPad. I will show you the most important tools, how you can get started and create any 3D interior. I have already made a video about SketchUp a few weeks ago where I explained the different tools and what you can do with it. You can check it out if you want, I will add the link in the description below. There's also a free cheat sheet you can download that might be helpful in your learning process. So let's get started. Let's open SketchUp and tap on New Model. First of all, choose the units that fits your scale. You have options like decimal inches, meters, or feet. I use the centimeter option. So I'm going to 3D model a hotel room, and for this I will trace the floor, then decide the placement of things around. I use the rectangle tool to trace the floor. You can just trace a random rectangle here and then change the dimensions on this little box there. Use the offset tool to create the thickness of the walls. Now, let's trace the walls of the bathroom. And I will quickly plan the room just to know where will be the bed, the storage areas, the shower and stuff. If you already have a plan drawing ready, you can import it to SketchUp and directly 3D model on it here. In this case, I only have a little sketch with some dimensions, so I'm tracing the plan from scratch. Now we have the bathroom, I will just add the main door here and the bathroom door that I forgot. We can place the storage areas, the bed, the table, and the bedside tables. Alright, now it's an important step. We're going to create the walls by using the push-pull tool to extrude walls upward like this. I just wrote 250 cm, but it can be more of course. Oops, and I will just erase those lines. And yeah, now we have our empty hotel room. Now it might be difficult to 3D model or place furniture inside these walls as it might be tight. This is why I like to use the Create Section tool that you can find when you tap on the three dots on the left side of your screen. Then I select one side of my 3D model and we'll have a section that you can move like this. You can create one for each side if you want and move them according to the area you're modeling. Don't forget to activate the cut if it doesn't work. Before adding anything on this, I select the whole and I create a group. This is very important to know. Grouping objects make it very easy to select, to organize or to edit objects without affecting others. So for example, now I can trace on it and if I decide to delete these, it just doesn't affect these other lines because they are part of a group. Anyway, I'm drawing the shower wall frame. To paint or to add a color, tap on the Materials tab on the right panel. From there, you can select any color you want, or you can also download any materials you want from the 3D warehouse. I also want to download a glass material for the shower wall. And that's it. Let's not forget to make it a group. You can double tap to select the whole, then create group. Now I can duplicate it to create the door side. Let's also add a handle. To enter a group, you can double tap on it. Then you will see everything around in light gray. That's how you know you are in a group. To leave it, you can tap anywhere else on the screen. Now let's quickly trace the shower base. Instead of tracing everything by yourself, you can check the 3D Warehouse, which is an online library of 3D models that you can download from. It's free and you usually have a lot of choices. For example, I will download the shower column from there and this one is perfect, then we can place it. If you want to move an object in a specific direction, you'll have some tools on the top right side where you can choose to lock in which side you want to move. Okay, great. Now I will trace the bathroom furniture myself because I don't think I can find the model I have in mind in the 3D warehouse. Let's trace it on the side to see it better, then we can move it in. Sometimes the object you're searching for can come with a whole group of other things, so just download it, explode the group, and erase all the other things you don't want to use. You can also edit the things you download, like changing the color or resizing. Let's trace a mirror. I will just move the section here to see better. Alright, now let's add a toilet. This one is good. I will rotate it. And yeah, nice. Now we can add materials to the walls. I was thinking of a white gray marble. Don't forget to double tap on the main group to be able to edit it. And yes, this is nice. I want a different tile for this wall. This one is good, but the scale is too small. By the way, you can edit the material details by tapping on it, and I will change the dimensions here. And yeah, that's better. I'm going to place the door now. And we're done with the bathroom for now. Let's place a bed. There are so many choices. I will select this one. The size seems to fit, but I don't want to keep the lights and the headboard, so I double tap on it, as this is a group, then delete them. Alright, let's create our own headboard. I will add a fabric texture on this, maybe something gray. And I will trace some wall decorations like wall moldings. I just trace one, then make it a group to duplicate it as much as I would like to. Nice! I will see if I can find a good wallpaper. And this one is nice. We can make this some wooden panels. We can either add a material directly, but I think I prefer to download a 3D model of a wooden panel. And yes, this is what I was searching for. Let's resize it and edit it to fit the area. Not bad, right? I can draw now the wall lights. Let's just change a bit the moldings to create a good composition. And that's it. I forgot to paint the other walls. And I will change the section to cut the other side so I can start modeling there. Let's create the table and the coffee machine corner. And this can be the side where we can place the TV on it. I forgot to place the coffee machine on the table. I will also add some moldings on this side. And lastly, a chair. And maybe a wall decoration just there. And that's it. I will draw the windows now and a curtain. Lastly, let's do the floor. I was thinking of a wooden floor. There are actually different ways to do it. The easiest would be to select and place the material directly. But if you have a specific material you want to import with specific dimensions, and also if you have a lot of patience, you can draw all of them yourself and try your materials. By the way, you can change the direction and position of the textures. Tap here on texture, hold the green arrow and move it around. Tap on the eyedropper on the top right, then tap the texture you've just edited and color all the other tiles. In this case, it doesn't need to be precise, so that's not what I'm gonna do in here. I just wanted to show this as an example. So I've just placed the material directly on the floor. Anyway, I will add the bedside tables I have just downloaded from the 3D warehouse. And I forgot to model the storage area. Let's add a door. It doesn't need to be also wooden, by the way. I can make it white gray, for example. And lastly, let's add the final details, some decorations here and there. Sometimes I also like to add some shadows and change the field of view. You can also rotate the section cuts to create nice views from different angles. And last thing, there is an AI render tool just there that lets you write a prompt and generate a render of your 3D model. I think this is a great feature. I don't know how well it works as I have only tried it a few times, but if you are interested to know more, I can make another video exploring this tool. Let me know. And that's it. This is how you can create a 3D model of an interior in SketchUp. You can use the same tools to create infinite possibilities of 3D models, materials, and textures for any kind of interior. Let me know if you have any questions. If you want to learn SketchUp in depth and fast, I also offer one-on-one coachings. I can take only 2 persons per month to really focus on learning fast. So if you're interested, just reach out to me in the email in the description below. If you still have some time, you can check this other video here and see you in the next video. Bye!